Joined this evening by Michael Ashtrue, if you're not familiar with who he is, the Commissioner of Social Security. We appreciate your time.
Thank you. Happy to be here.
Yeah, you're in Toledo today for the start of a new hearing office here at the One Seagate building. Tell people what that's about.
We run basically the largest system of justice in the world. We'll take in about 800,000 appeals of disability cases, and we've had backlog cases for more than a decade. So we have a big effort going on to improve our productivity and to expand in places where the backlogs have been the worst. So Toledo has been one of our primary goals as an additional hearing office here. We've been working on it for 3 years. Really happy to be here. We've got terrific people. They're gung-ho. We'll have 10 new judges here. And it should start making a big difference within a matter of months.
Yeah, and sometimes it took 2 years for people to get a hearing. Now you're going to try to get it closer to a year.
It's been about 2 years in Ohio, generally 4 years ago. Those numbers are dropping dramatically. It's probably on average about 450, 475 in Ohio now, but it's dropping. With this office and the one we opened yesterday in Akron, it should be less than a year by the springtime, and we'll continue to improve to our goal of 270 days.
Okay, the Social Security Administration has been in the news lately, a lot of talk about you. One thing is, I was talking to somebody the other day, and Social Security came up, and one complaint for somebody is, why am I paying into something I don't think is going to be there in 30, 40, 50 years? What is your sense of the longevity of Social Security for people that might be 30, 40, 50 these days?
So, Social Security Administration is going to be here long after I'm gone. There's a little bit of hysteria because people react to the actuary's terms of solvency. So if you and I, if you said to me I'm insolvent, right, I would say, well, really too bad, you can't pay your bills, there's really nothing left. When the actuaries use it for us, it just simply means that we can't pay full benefits. So we can pay full benefits for another 27 years. After that, if nothing changes, and I do think Congress is going to act in the next few years, we would be paying a little over 75% of benefits. So that's not great, but it's also not nothing, and it gives a sense that even if nothing happens, there's still a pretty substantial base of benefits there to pay going forward indefinitely. So we're going to be here, and I think the American public is so attached to the concept of Social Security that the people who are trying to scare the public are just not going to win.
What do you think about some of the talk of raising the retirement age? Are you in favor of that, against it?
Right now, that debate has to happen in Congress. There's an infinite number of ways to try to fix the system, but at the end of the day, you either have to raise revenue or reduce benefits in some way, and that's painful. Mm-hmm. That's a debate that's starting to happen with the Simpson-Bowles Fiscal Commission reporting, but I think it's important to remember it's the first step in a long process. They haven't even voted as a commission yet. All we have really now is sort of a straw man that's been put out by the two co-chairmen. And even if their report is adopted, that's interesting, but at the end of the day, Congress has to act. And that's probably going to take a while. This is a debate that's probably going to take at least 2 years and may take 4 years, but it's an important one to have, and it's important for Congress to act sooner because there's less pain if you can spread something out over a longer period of time. And I do think it's important for younger Americans entering the workforce, like my two children, to have confidence that the system is going to be there for them.
And I think confidence is a lot of probably what your worry is these days. Do you almost have to have a marketing campaign almost to prove to people that it's going to be around because there is so much worry about it?
Well, we do try to get the facts out, and it's hard because it's so technical, and you look at the annual trustees report, it's 500 pages, it's very dense reading. And it's very easy to confuse people, but I think the key facts are there is more than adequate money through 2037. After that point in time, it is inadequate to pay the full level of benefits now, but there's still a substantial amount of resources there. So the question really is, how much change of what kind do we want going forward?
Okay, Commissioner, we appreciate your time. Great. Thank you very much for joining us on the Talkback. Commissioner Michael Ashtrue with the Social Security Administration, and that is your Talkback.